case you're not familiar, grubs are the larval stage of the Japanese beetle, the mask chafer beetle. There are all kinds of different beetles, but we're just going to call them June bugs from here. Now, I'm going to give you some fun little research keywords to look for and some interesting things that I think will be a little bit fun through this. But let's just kind of understand the life cycle of those. So mama June bugs fly around in June. They'll eat your bushes. They'll eat your trees. They'll eat your shrubs. I used to catch them on all kinds of different things. And as they're doing that, they are laying eggs in well-watered lawns. A mama June bug wants to lay her eggs in a beautiful green lawn because a beautiful green lawn indicates a lot of roots. If it's a dead brown dormant lawn or a weedy lawn, there's not as many roots there for her baby grub worms to feed on, and she wants to provide them with a good nursery experience. So she's going to lay those in your lawn because you're a lawn care nut. Your lawn is green. You've been taking care of it, and it looks like it's got some juicy roots. Now, we're going to talk about treating and why you should treat and all of that, because I don't want you to think just because you got juicy roots that that means you need to go ahead and get a treatment down for grubs, but it's just one of those things to consider. If you're going to let your lawn go into summer dormancy, that's a whole nother strategy. That said, though, those grubs that are laid in the lawn in June and July, and there's some earlier May, June beetles, and there's some later June, July beetles, and it can change. If you're in South Florida, there might be a few different generations of them. But for the rest of the world outside of South Florida, they're going to come in May, June, July, possibly into August, but that's really the time when you want to prevent that. And what you want to do is you don't want those larvae to be able to feed because the eggs are laid in the soil surface. They hatch, they burrow down into the soil, and they create this little worm. It's not a worm, but that's what it looks like. It's called a grub worm. It looks like a little shrimp under the lawn. And those little shrimp, they feed on grass roots. And you can imagine as they're chewing on the grass roots, everything above is dying. And they're chewing all during the summer, and there's a bunch of different things that cause brown spots in lawns over the summer. We're going to talk about disease problems here. But the other thing that happens is, and so by the way, every brown spot you see is what I'm getting at is not grub worms, but sometimes it's masked, or sometimes people think it's a disease when it's a grub, and the grubs are left to go, and this and that, right? And so they'll feed all during the summer. The other thing that happens in the summer is a lot of you will not catch up on your watering. So if you have a hot summer, your lawn will start to go into dormancy and turn brown. And those brown areas will be masked if there's grubs there also feeding at the same time. So there's a lot of things that can hide the grubs. They can kind of be covert during the summer. And this is maybe why you want to put a preventative down so you have that peace of mind. But either way, they feed on those roots all during the summer and through the fall. They get big and fat, and you'll see most of the damage coming up in the fall, especially if you have let your lawn go dormant in the summer or it's been struggling in the summer and you've decided, I'm going to have to just kind of call no joy and let it go a little bit, wait for the fall because it will recover in fall. Grass just naturally does. By the way, there's nothing wrong with summer dormancy in a lawn. If you're somebody that can't irrigate, you're just going to let it go. That's okay. You still want to get it a little water so the crowns don't die, but it's okay to let it stay dormant for a couple of months in the summer. So you wait for it to come out in the fall, whether you let it go dormant or whether you just had some struggles, and there will be areas that won't come back, and you'll go and peel them up, and they'll come up like carpet, and you'll find these little shrimp, many of them underneath the lawn there, and you'll see them. So that's grubs. They feed. If you don't find them, whatever, then they'll go down deep when things get cold, and they'll just hang out underneath the ground all during the wintertime. And then as the spring comes in and soil temperatures rise to 55, they'll come back up again. They'll take a few munches, and then in May, June, bam, they fly out again. And now the mama June bug starts all over. It's a different mama June bug this time, obviously. And the cycle just continues. So that's your life cycle of the June bug and the grub. So the idea is that you want to prevent that larval stage from ever feeding. And if you can prevent that larval stage from feeding or kill it as it begins to feed, then it will not survive to become a mama June bug. And it won't do any damage to you this year. And then hopefully it reduces the populations for you the next year.